No. Oh, wow, man. These penalties in the first lap are ridiculous. You have to give up so much time. It's totally ridiculous. Look at that.
What the fuck are you doing, fucking idiot?
Wow. 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 Looks like your car is toast. Hello, welcome back from the moon. The Eagle has landed. Welcome back to iRacing. Laguna Seca IMSA GTE. Pretty high strength of field. In car number 14, qualified in 5th. Should be fun. I'm pretty quick here. If I don't crash or get shot to the moon. So I'll have to focus quite a bit, I think. 45 minutes, pit stop as usual. Let's do this. Good. I was on the wrong side of the track, but I only lost one spot, so that's okay. Oh, big gap behind me. Something must have happened. He's right behind me. I won't get blue flags. Gotta be careful. He'll slice back through the field. And although this is a pretty high strength of field in GTE, that doesn't mean it's high strength of field in DP. Because of iRacing split logic and how popular GTE is compared to DP. It's complicated. Very easy to do with the Ferrari. Thank you, sir.
1.6 seconds. Need to close this gap. Strange. Come on. Push, push, push.
DP, we're trying to raise here.
I think that DP is holding up the guys behind me, which I'm very thankful for. I've been in the same situation in another race this week. It's quite annoying. But, yeah. If you watch ELMS in real world, or even more so the Michelin Le Mans Cup, it's much worse there. LMP3 gentleman drivers and quick GT or GT3 drivers, they mix up quite a lot. Actually, I can't see the DP on the relative. Maybe it was something else. What am I doing? Doesn't help either. I need some air.
We're not racing each other. That's like my trip for me, but I was in people. I was like, yeah, a few feet between each other.
Damn.
What I'm getting at is there's no point in racing me all the way to the corkscrew when we're in different classes. I don't think you tried to. It looks like you tried to tuck behind you and that could have got him. But again, I wasn't too close. Just trying to get benefit of the boat. I can't hear you all that well. Whatever.
That's a DP again. Quick shot you saw him on the left. I don't know if you could see him.
Thank you.
Man, I'm so focused. I have great trouble talking. get a little bit closer. Slipstream isn't a huge topic here, but still helps. I need every help I can get. The GT3 car there? Nope. So this is really, this whole group is up to P1. Nobody really escaped yet. Ah, come on. KDP behind me, 2 seconds. Not the smartest idea to brake on dirt there. It's very easy to lose the rear end there. Been there, done that.
What the fuck, man?
Corner.
Paralelo ahí.
No.
Tarifa, soy mucho más rápido que tú, tío. Te pones a cerrar huecos.
Ya, pero ficha, así no se puede tirar. O por lo menos respeta mi zona.
There we go.
Ah.
What a silly mistake. That was super close with the DP. So I lost 3 spots, is that correct? Yeah. That's annoying. Somehow I need to try to cool down the rear tires again. But as you can see, lots of Ferraris actually here this week. It's too early. But the Ferrari is a bit tricky sometimes, especially in the downhill braking zones and under acceleration if you're stupid like me. Relied too much on the traction control there. Early. So yeah, these two guys are in reach, and then unfortunately I need a bit of luck. No.
What, not yet?
Late. Alright, I'm losing.
What the hell are you doing?
Losing concentration now.
You just get off the track. That's probably not 30 ever. That part of that was that killed me.
11 more laps of fuel. Pit stop is a bit tricky here. Pit lane entry, more specifically.
Why you do this?
Can't remember which car, but in one of my recent races here, I'm sure it's on video, I was confused because pit crew changed my tire, so despite I unchecked them in the pit stop options. And now I'm pretty sure I know why that happened. That pit lane entry turn is very, very tight and you tend to just cut it a little bit, which makes the simulation think you left pit lane for a very short time. Damn, I'm losing them. And doing this when you this guy has problems. When you, so to speak, when you re-enter the pit lane after the apex, all the pit options get reset. There is a way to change the default setting in some INI file, but I just gotta be careful. So the gap has opened up to almost double now. 3 seconds. These guys are not slow either. 5 incidents. I gotta be careful with the safety rating too as well, by the way. We're at 2.1 or so. And it's the last day of the season. And if I remember correctly, if I fall below 2, then I will lose my A license. Which normally I don't really care. But next season they will make the Formula One series.
Thank you.
Fixed setup, which will mean that many people will race it, I'm sure. And it should be interesting, and you need the A license for that series. It's the only road series for which you need the A license, I think. Maybe the Long Pain Endurance series, I'm not sure. No, I don't think so. Time to focus now. Shut up.
Thank you.
Good. Bit of GT3 traffic should help me. Or not. Oh, it's actually a GTE backmarker. Oh. And there's two GT3 cars actually. If we're exiting pits, right ahead of me. Ah. Which means they are battling for position and won't let me through very easily. Okay, gotta pass one guy. Actually. Entry, but at least I didn't crash into the wall. Problem is, I will be in traffic anyway, though. Or will I? All clear. Got a bit of clean air. Okay, focus time thing.
Come on, man. I'm 34, get off the track.
Gaining on the DP car, that's worrying. And there's two GT3 cars. So much for clean air. That's one GT3 car. Oh man, DP is holding up the GT3.
No, I'm
really bad. That's really bad as well. At least I didn't crash, but this way I won't be able to make any move on the other guys. Bad luck, but nothing I can do. No. Can only hope the others have even more traffic. Come on. Okay, misunderstanding. There they are in the pits. Oh, we're past Jovan. Oh, confused. Sorry if I have no idea how to pronounce his name, but I know his name. He's pretty quick, usually. So what happened there? Where am I? No idea. Oh yeah, that... Ooh, I lost so much time. Juan Carlos, I think that's one of the two guys I chased.
Thank you.
8 seconds ahead. Oh boy. Another guy in the pits. Yes, I'll pass him. So in P7, okay. So I gained that one spot passing Joan Kini. And I'm very far away now. Okay, just continue. Who knows? Bloody hell. I something dropped on the floor. I hope it wasn't a screw from my rig or steering wheel or something. Exciting. Minutes remain. Who's that? Oh damn, I have... Somehow I missed that there's a GTE car right behind me. Damn it! Poor position, okay. Where did he come from? Almost lost it. I think he's quicker. Minutes. Thanks. Thanks.
down.
Okay, things getting dicey now. Gotta stay tight there. Or else he'd probably stick his nose in the gap. Very bad. Okay. Yeah, I think you gotta give him that. That wasn't off track. Where?
Should have at least covered the inside. It was stupid.
It's not over yet. Two minutes. Bad.
Yeah, he's just quicker.
Oh. Okay. Should be interesting. Two more laps, I guess. Tires are a bit problematic already. Doing something wrong here in this section. Entry into corkscrew in this corner. Good. Okay. This is my only chance. Well defended. Too late. Okay, another GT3 car.
Totally messed it up. That was my chance. And ninth incident. Oh, come on. This was such a good opportunity. Looked in the mirror, didn't see, slow down. Oh man. Yeah, it was a good battle towards the end, but unfortunately, yeah, I could have finished so much higher. One mistake and boof. Nevertheless, really good pace by now in GT. I'm pretty, very happy about that. I mean, this should be a really high strength of field. I may have lost my A license, but who cares?